Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about contraction and relaxation of smooth muscle. Role of calcium. As in other muscle types, the changes in sarcoplasmic calcium ion concentration plays a major role in smooth muscle contraction. Changes in sarcoplasmic calcium ion concentration plays a major role in smooth muscle contraction. The strength of the stimulus, the degree of stretch or amount of neurotransmitter or hormone reaching the cell membrane acting on the smooth muscle fiber can be graded. Accordingly, the change in cytosolic calcium concentration may be minute, more or very high, producing different degrees of contraction. The cytosolic calcium concentration is increased mainly by entry of calcium from the interstitial fluid, calcium in flux, or to some extent by its release from cytoplasmic calcium stores or calcium release. However, the concentration of calcium in cytosol decreases due to binding of calcium to calmodulin, pumping back of calcium to the sarcoplasmic reticulum and calcium efflux. Okay. See once again, the strength of the stimulus, the degree of stretch or amount of neurotransmitter or hormone reaching cell membrane acting on the smooth muscle fiber can be graded. Accordingly, change in cytosolic calcium concentration may be minute, more or very high, producing different degrees of concentration. The cytosolic calcium concentration is increased mainly by entry of calcium from interstitial fluid or to some extent by its release from cytosolic calcium stores or calcium release. However, the concentration of calcium in cytosol decreases due to binding of calcium to calmodulin, pumping back of calcium to sarcoplasmic reticulum and calcium efflux. Next, calcium influx. The calcium influx occurs through voltage-gated calcium channels, ligand-gated calcium channels, and a few leaky channels. The extracellular fluid calcium concentration is about 12,000 times higher than that of cytoplasm. This high inwardly directed gradient favors calcium entry into the smooth muscle as soon as calcium channels open. Calcium influx. And the calcium influx occurs through voltage-gated calcium channels, ligand-gated calcium channels, and a few leaky channels. The extracellular fluid calcium concentration is about 12,000 times higher than that of cytoplasm. 12,000 times higher than that of cytoplasm. That is 12 lakhs nanomole per liter versus 100 nanomole per liter. This high invariably directed gradient favors calcium entry into the smooth muscle as soon as calcium channels open. Next, calcium release. The calcium release from the sarcoplasmic reticulum takes place by two mechanisms. Calcium release from sarcoplasmic reticulum takes place by two mechanisms. And the first mechanism is inositol triphosphate mediated pathway activated by second messengers. And calcium induced calcium release, CICR, calcium induced calcium release mechanism, in which some amount of calcium influx stimulates further calcium release from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Next, binding of calcium to calmodulin. Binding of calcium to calmodulin. Binding of calcium to calmodulin starts when cytoplasmic calcium concentration is above 10^-7 molarity and is completed at 10^-4 molarity. Pumping back of calcium to sarcoplasmic reticulum. Pumping back of calcium to sarcoplasmic reticulum. Pumping back of calcium to sarcoplasmic reticulum is mediated via a calcium ATPase present on the membrane of sarcoplasmic reticulum and calcium efflux and calcium efflux to the extracellular fluid occurs by sodium calcium antiport and the process of secondary active transport and by calcium ATPase, both the mechanisms being present on the cell membrane. In smooth muscles, tension is generated in the same manner as in the skeletal muscles by the attachment of energizer cross bridges to actin, followed by detachment from and reattachment to actin. Okay. Next, molecular basis of contraction. As described above, calcium concentration increases in the cell mainly by influx from extracellular fluid and partly by release from sarcoplasmic reticulum. The following stepwise process takes place sequentially to culminate in the muscle contraction. Rise in cytosolic calcium mainly due to calcium influx from extracellular fluid and calcium binds to calmodulin, following which activation of myosin light chain kinase occurs and calmodulin is a small protein associated with myosin light chain kinase, which is a calcium calmodulin dependent protein kinase. When calmodulin binds with 4 calcium ions, the calcium calmodulin complex activates myosin light chain kinase. Activated myosin light chain kinase brings about phosphorylation of myosin head and stimulates the myosin ATPase activity. And myosin light chain kinase utilizes one molecule of ATP and causes phosphorylation of regulatory light chains of myosin on serine at position 19. This phosphorylation process is critical for activation of myosin ATPase. Increased myosin ATPase activity and myosin actin interaction initiates the cross bridge cycle and shortening occurs due to sliding filament mechanism. The myosin ATPase enzyme is activated in the phosphorylated myosin head, causing hydrolysis of one ATP molecule. This energizes myosin head, that is myosin ADP inorganic phosphate complex, binds with actin, producing the power stroke and pulls the thin filament toward the center of the thick filament. And ADP and inorganic phosphate are released during this process. The cross bridge detaches from actin when another ATP molecule attaches to myosin, reducing its affinity for actin. Then myosin ATPase enzyme hydrolyzes ATP, resulting in the attachment of myosin head with actin. Okay, next. Thus, the cross-bridge cycle continues provided that myosin head remains the phosphorylated. As the cross-bridge cycle continues as long as the required cytoplasmic calcium concentration is maintained. Because the phosphorylation depends on the cytosolic calcium level. In skeletal muscles, the contraction proceeds with activation of thin filament proteins. Actin linker regulation. Whereas in smooth muscle, The process of contraction is myosin basin. We call this myosin linker regulation. Next, mechanism of relaxation. And the relaxation is brought about by deep phosphorylation of myosin light chain by enzyme myosin light chain phosphatase. This enzyme is constantly active during the periods of relaxation or contraction. During contraction, the rate of myosin light chain kinase inducer phosphorylation exceeds the rate of myosin light chain phosphatase inducer dephosphorylation, and therefore amount of phosphorylated myosin increases in the cell, which allows the contraction to proceed. When the cytoplasmic calcium concentration decreases, calcium is detached from the calmodulin, resulting in decline in myosin light chain kinase activity. Consequently, the activity of myosin light chain phosphatase predominates, causing dephosphorylation of myosin. The myosin light chain ATPase enzyme remains inactive and relaxation ensues. The phosphorylation and dephosphorylation of the myosin light chain is regulated by respective rise in phosphorylation and dephosphorylation of the myosin light chain is regulated by respective rise and fall of cytosolic calcium concentration. Okay. And this is about the mechanism of contraction and relaxation of smooth muscle. Okay guys, coming to the flow chart. The calcium influx into the smooth muscle cells causes the binding of calcium with calmodulin-dependent myosin light chain kinase. This causes the phosphorylation of myosin and increases myosin ATPase activity. And myosin binds with actin, resulting in cross-bridge formation, causes the contraction of muscle. And dephosphorylation of myosin by myosin light chain phosphatase. This causes the latch bridge state. We call this sustained contraction or slow relaxation. Okay, this is about mechanism of contraction and relaxation of smooth muscle. Okay guys, if you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.